Good morning, guys. Kyle here at FCP Euro, and this morning we're working on our project CLK 550. This one's a 2007 model year, and what we'll be doing today is dealing with an oil leak. These cars have a crankcase breather system with a seal on the back of the driver's side head. The seal has a rubber O-ring. Over time, it gets hard and brittle and fails to seal. Oil will drip onto the manifold, it'll burn off, and you'll smell it in the cabin. So we're going to take care of that today, as well as the other two plugs on the back of the cylinder head. Let's get started. Similar to a lot of other repairs on the vehicle, we've got to get the cosmetic covers out of the way. We also need to remove the engine air box. There's normally a clip back here on this vehicle. It is missing. From there, we've got caps on the back of this head. We've got the seal that we're replacing on the back of this head and one additional cap. I'm going to pop the caps off first. I like to kind of just work my hand around the perimeter and pop it off like that. And that's out. We'll grab the new one, throw on there. And you can kind of see the majority of this is a hard plastic, but then you also have the rubber impregnated in to form the seal. And I'm just working my way around to make sure that's sealed nice and tight. That one's good. I'm gonna try to pop off the next one. Same deal. Pry it off. And then work my way around the perimeter. You can see that it's already hard and brittle and chipping off. Popping the new one on. Same deal with this one. We're gonna pop this hose off, the breather hose off the seal. That's off. We're gonna kind of get it up and out of the way. And then we've got four very hard to reach T30 fasteners that we need to remove. They are in a pretty tight spot. I'm just gonna come in here with the ratchet, loosen it up first, a quarter inch, and then I'm gonna back it out by hand because it's just such a tight space to work in. I'm gonna do the same for the other fastener down here. The other two fasteners are not easy, and there's just not enough space to get in there. So I'm going to get a pair of vice grips, clamp it on the tool, and use that to get it out. Now that it's loose, similar to the other fasteners, we're just going to do it by hand. All right, we've got one more. Way another Netherland. All right, so now we're going to pry the vent seal out. So this is what our new vent seal looks like. This is what we'll be putting in. The design has been revised a couple of times. I believe the latest part number ends in 0631, but we will leave some information below. The new one pops in, and there is a dowel to help you locate. Let me grab the old one so I can show you. There is a dowel that helps to locate the piece in place. If you're in the wrong position, you're not going to be able to lay it flush against the cylinder head. Tacking all four in by hand first, and then we'll torque it down. All right, time to torque these things down. It's a really tight space, so you just want to be patient and just take your time and get it torqued down. These don't need to be too tight, so don't go crazy with it. The last step is to take your breather hose, pop it onto your vent seal. All right, it's time to get the engine air box back on the engine. Line up your air hose, line up your secondary air hose so that you're not fighting it after it's all the way down. Forward cover, filter housing cover, and that's it. So that wraps up the repair on our project CLK 550. If you like what you've seen today, hit the like button and subscribe. Thanks for watching.